the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to use this opportunity to pray for President Donald Trump. He might not be good, but Lord, all the steps he's taking, prayer, openly declaring you Jesus as Lord, openly handing over the things that belong to God, to the pastors and the priests. Lord, I ask of God, my super robot shut at him. Show him a token of your Lord. Let there be a token of your Lord. Let there be a token of your Lord. In America, oh God. Let there be a token of your Lord.
Yes, Lord.
The enemy has gathered because he has come to change nature, even things around him. The earth. It's as if the earth is fighting against him. But Lord, in that power, I decree, peace be still in America.
Amen.
I command every storm, every power that is trying, oh God, to prove to the world that Trump, what he's doing, bringing back God to America, that is not going to be a reality. Lord, anything working against that, today I silence them in the
name
of Jesus. I command every storm to be still.
Yes, God.
I command every disaster to be still.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus. Lord, encourage yourself. The world might not like it, but one thing is certain. Righteousness exalts a nation. Sin is a reproach. All he's targeting is righteousness. So that America will be exalted again. So that America will be blessed again. Because if heaven, until the Spirit is released from on high, the wilderness can never be a fruitful field. Lord, cause America to become a fruitful field again. To become a blessed nation again. Now that he's following the ways of his father, Abraham Lincoln, he's following the ways of his father, the forefathers of America, that through revival, America was blessed thus far. Lord, to you be all the glory. Every enemy of the state, every enemy of the state, Lord, Marcus Gabriel, Apostle Paul said, be blinded. Until you repent, let them be blinded in whatever they are doing. Cause America to come back. And that will be an example to every other nation. That righteousness exalts a nation, and sin is a reproach. Lord, I bless this youth that you have given unto me. I have no future without them. I have no testimony without them. I have failed as a pastor without them. Therefore, Lord, if I have found favor before thee, cause me to succeed through them. Cause me to succeed through them. Bless them. They will not make mistakes in their marriages. They will not make mistakes in their spouses.
Amen.
Father, they will make the right choice.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. In their workplace, you shall protect them.
Amen.
In their schools, you shall protect them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for this wonderful youth. Father, they shall do more than their father, their grandfather, Archbishop Wesley. They shall change their nation. They shall affect the political department of their nation. They shall affect the four, seven pillars of their nation, the social media, the every department, the legal department, the entertainment department, education department, whatever department, political department. Father, they shall turn this nation around in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray for the Joseph of Australia. Begin to teach them. Begin to equip them with revelation. Begin to direct them. Begin to move them to their different position. That they will start gathering the best for this nation, Australia. Australia shall remain a blessed nation. Australia shall remain a nation that has future. Because the future of Australia, the Joseph of Australia, Pariba Kobe Maha, has not been forgotten by the Christian community. Lord, thank you for all you have done. And many more things you are about to do. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, even as we share the grace of fellowship.